Hello everyone, my name is Jiakan. I'm a software engineer here at Statsig. Today I'm going to talk about how to put your new feature behind a feature gate using Statsig. Alright, as you can see, we have a game called Rock, Paper, Scissors here. And it's a pretty simple game. You can decide what move you want to play and it will tell you whether you won or lost against the computer. Now as the owner of the game, I have a feeling that the font size for these buttons are too small. So increasing the font size might get people to play my game more, so I want to test that out. But I'm not totally sure about my theory, so maybe I should put this behind the feature gate so that if I see people actually not playing more games but less, I can always turn off the feature. So what you do is you can create your own project, in this case Rock, Paper, Scissors in Statsig, and then create a feature gate. We're gonna name the feature gate show larger tags. All right, now our feature gate is created. As you can see here, by default it always returns false for everyone because we don't have any rule here. Now I'm going to switch back to my code editor and show you how to use the feature gate in the code. As you can see, using Statsig in your code is actually really easy. All you have to do is install the library and then call statsig.initialize to initialize the SDK. In the initialize function, we take a couple parameters. The first one is the API key, which you can get from the Statsig console. And then you need to tell us the user, who the user is. And the most important part of the user object is the user ID. After that, you can see we call the render function, which displays all the button. And what we can do to display a, to make the button text larger, we can just do button.style.fontsize equals, let's say 20 pixel for this feature. And we can switch back to the game and the font size are bigger now. Now, if we want to put this behind the feature gate, all you have to do is call let show larger text statsig.checkGate. And here the parameter is the feature gate's name. So we can go back to the feature gate, copy the name of the gate, and paste it here. That's it. The value now is basically the user's pass or fail value for this feature gate. So we can write code here to say if show larger text, then change the font size. We can go back to the demo, refresh the page, and now the font size are small again because everyone fails the feature gate by default. All right, let's say your new feature has gone through many rounds of testing and now is shipped to production, but it's behind the feature gate, so all of your users are still seeing the small font size. But you are ready to roll it out to your users. What you can do is come back to the console, to the feature gate, click on add new rule, and if you do not have any targeting, you just want to roll it out to everyone, you can select a everyone criteria, and give it a name, and select your pass percentage. For the purpose of this demo, we're gonna set it to be 100%, but you can set it to be anything between 0 and 100. Click on save changes here. And now the feature gate is shipped to everyone. We can go back to the game, refresh the page, and you can see the feature gate is successfully shipped to for this user, and they're getting the larger font size. And say if you realize it's not performing as you expected, it's actually causing people to play the game less, what you can do is simply edit the feature gate and turn it back off to 0%. Save changes. Now the feature is no longer in production and all of your users will be seeing the smaller text again.